We have an hour together for yoga, half of which we're going to be spending seated in a chair, and the other half we're coming down to the earth for a more restorative end. So for the restorative part of the class, I have with me two yoga bolsters here. Of course, I'm not expecting anybody to have any yoga bolsters at home, but you can take some firm pillows, you can roll up a couple of bath towels. These ones are circular, they don't have to be. Anything that you have handy, the best props are the ones that you have, so don't feel like it needs to be perfect. I put two of those, I've got a blanket, and I've got two yoga blocks. Of course, the blanket can also be a towel, and the two yoga blocks can be some sturdy books wrapped in a towel. Anything that you really, again, have handy is the best. So I'm going to put those props off to the side, and then we'll begin our first half in the chair. So making sure your chair is stable and comfortable, and that you've got some space around you so you're not knocking houseplants flying as you're moving. Taking a comfortable seat, deciding how wide it's comfortable for you to have your legs, whether you want to use the back of the chair for support or sit away from it. There's no wrong way to do this. This is a very gentle class. We're going to be focusing on the breath and reducing the stress response, getting into that relaxation response so we can come down to the earth and really get that deep relaxation for the last part of class. Rooting down through your feet, and your seat where it's connected to the chair, so we feel the earth underneath us. And from there, lifting up through the torso, through the crown of the head, chin drawn in and back a little, rolling the shoulders a couple of times back and down to ease any tension, and then settle the shoulders away from the ears. We'll take a big breath in. Exhale, release into the support, and let's take a couple of breaths like that. Feel free to close your eyes or soften your gaze down. Letting go of your day, your week so far, or if there's any particular tension and tightness in your body or on your mind, see if you can soften that as we come back to this moment. And allow yourself this time to be able to give your body what it needs for that movement and deep rest. This is a practice. It means that it gets easier the more we do it. But there's never a time that it's perfect. And that is just fine. We're just showing up, deciding how we feel, and adjusting the movements and the shapes for us in this moment. So, leaving behind any expectations of maybe a yoga practice you had before, even if it was just yesterday, or how you would like it to be. And let's take this one breath at a time. So as we settle in to that shape that you've decided on, let's just go inside and notice how you're feeling in this moment. Gentle with yourself, stay away from the stories, and just notice emotions that are present and things on your mind. And then notice your body as it sits here in this rest, letting go of tightness, tension, discomfort as best as you can. Notice the places in your body that need a little extra care today. Make a mental note of being gentle with those areas. Notice the ease present in your body in different places, even if it's your pinky finger, the tip of your nose. If there is tightness and tension present, is there anything you can Notice the breath in the body as it comes and goes, smoothing and steadying. We start to deepen the inhale and lengthen the exhale gently. Maybe breathing in and out through the nose if that's comfortable for you. Smoothing the breath in and out as best as we can. And if the breath doesn't feel smooth, that's perfectly fine. We do our best to steady it out. To listen to the exhale breath. Let the inhale take care of itself, and on that exhale, listen to the sound of the breath all the way down to the bottom. Put an extra 5% energy in that exhale, making it just a little longer than it was. And I'm going to call this that ocean exhale. Anytime we put emphasis on the exhale of the breath, that is the breath, the part of the breath that is responsible for our relaxation response. So focusing on the sound and the steadiness of that exhale all the way down to the bottom of the breath. Let the inhales take care of themselves. Notice how that exhale has a quality of softness and letting go. If there's any straining or forcing that exhale, see if you can step back a little from that, even if that exhale gets a little softer. We're listening to the sound of it, smoothing it out all the way down to the bottom. Feet and see them rising from there, lifting up through the heart space and focusing on that exhale breath. And when you're ready, with the tip of your nose, start to create slow, lazy circles in the air, inhaling and exhaling. No forcing here, just bringing a little movement into the cervical spine. Eyes soft, lowered or closed if that feels good to you. And we start to notice where and how we experience this movement in our body. Allowing that movement to be your own. There's no particular right or wrong here. Just slow, mindful movement. On exhale, when you're ready, we'll pause. Go around slowly, softly in the opposite direction. You might want to make that softer to start with as the body starts to get used to this direction. Inhaling and exhaling, noticing how that feels. Let's take another couple here. You can always rest, of course. And then at the end of that exhale, we'll pause and come back to center. Allowing those arms to dangle down nice and heavy next to us, and we're circling through those shoulders now. Inhaling up, exhaling down and round, whichever direction you're going in. One may feel very different from the other. Allow that to simply be as it is. Any intuitive adjustments to ease this movement into your body, go ahead. And then when you're ready, we'll pause and take that round in the opposite direction. Be gentle with yourself. fingertips can lift up, maybe even coming together, but allow those exhales to be slow and steady.
Making
making sure that as we dip one set of fingers down, the opposite shoulder draws back in space so it's not curling forward. Got that imaginary wall behind us, the base of the skull, the shoulder blades, the back of the pelvis. Keep the breath flowing, that ocean exhale, taking you down, and the inhale, shoulders over hips. Let's take two more either side. Notice how this feels in your body. We're strengthening not only that range of motion, but also through the core of the body. Keeping that breath in the forefront, coming all the way up to center, hands resting down, rooting to rise. Taking a big breath in. And exhaling it out, nice and slow. Nicely done. And then from there, inhaling and exhaling, coming into a gentle twist here, hands resting. This is the inhale. On the exhale, we're going to be twisting over towards the left side, glancing to the left, inhaling back to center, exhaling, twisting. And then we're going to come over to the right, and then we'll go from left to right. Inhaling to center, exhaling, twisting to the right, back to center. Let's take two more on this side, and then we'll go left to right and right to left. From here, back to center, exhale to one side, inhale through center, and exhale to the other side. Noticing how that feels. If you've done a lot in the shoulders, which we have, and the shoulders feel fatigued, then please stay here, hands resting. If you want to add on, as if you were holding a beach ball, let's inhale through center, arms come up and overhead as wide as feels comfortable in the shoulders. On the exhale, we'll take that beach ball down to the side of the hip on one side, inhaling up and overhead, exhaling to the other side. Very supportive. Inhaling and exhaling. Steady and smooth. Noticing how this feels. Noticing if anything's moving from the pelvis down, and try and keep that as stable and steady so you isolate that twist through the spine. Let's take two more either side unless you're resting. Smooth and steady. And then when you're ready, we'll come all the way back through center. Interlace the thumbs, let's reach up and lift up through the heart, lift up through the gaze, reach with those fingers, elbows bent or straight. And then on an exhale, shoulders over hips as we draw those hands down and release the hands. Once more, any intuitive movement through the shoulder. Let's take a big breath in. Exhale it out, nice and slow. Beautiful job. From here, we're going to root to rise, and then we're going to draw that right knee in towards us, giving yourself a little hand on the thigh underneath the knee or in front of that shin. Rooting down through the left leg as we still rise through the spine, and we're circling through with that right ankle. One direction, nice and slow. And then we'll pause and take that round in the opposite direction. And then from there, keeping that right hand cupped in the right knee, let's take that forward. You can, of course, support your leg under your thigh. And then we're just drawing circles in space with the hip here. Round in one direction, right foot is your rooting, so we rise from there. The next exhale, we pause and take that round in the opposite direction. So we're lubricating that right hip, or left hip. Mm-hmm. And then when you're ready, we'll take that foot all the way down and release some tension. From here, knees and ankles come in towards each other, and we'll take that right knee out towards the side. Option to come to the outer blade of that foot here. A nice flex in that ankle. Great place to stay here. If you have a yoga block or a stack of books that we talked about in the beginning of the class, I'm just gonna grab mine here and take that to the inside of those legs and take that outer blade of the foot up a little higher, getting in towards the hip here. Depending on your range of motion, maybe that outer ankle can come all the way on top of that left thigh. Rooting down to rise up. Flex in that ankle to keep the knee nice and safe. Hands on the ankle or knee to knee, depending on where you are. This is the inhale. On the exhale, with a long spine coming forward, inhaling up and exhaling down. Just easing into that right hip a little. Option to keep moving or come forward any amount and stay. Three breaths, long spine, wide collarbones, gaze is eye height. Keep that breath going, that ocean exhale for a couple more breaths. Always coming out early if you prefer. And then when you're ready, shoulders back over hips if they were forward, and we'll release that bind. Knees and ankles and towards each other, and this time over towards the left side. Going to the outer blade of the foot on the floor. If you do have anything to elevate and it feels supported, then you can take it there. Hands on knees. Option to take that ankle on top of that right thigh. Knee to ankle, supporting that flex in the ankle to keep that left knee nice and safe. Rooting to rise. This may be enough from sensation in the hip. Or this is the inhale. On the exhale, we're coming forward any amount, inhaling up, hinging from the hip space, so the spine is as long and straight as possible. Option to keep moving forward and back. Option to come forward and stay. And we breathe. Always making accommodations for your body. There is no wrong way to do any of this, as long as you're listening to yourself and what your body needs above all else. Staying for the last couple of breaths, unless you've come out early and are resting. On an exhale, we stay. On an inhale, drawing the shoulders up over the hips and releasing any binds. Washing the knees side to side, relieving tension. And we come back to root to rise. Steady the breath, listen to those ocean exhales all the way down to the bottom of that breath. Relieve any tension and tightness in your body. Stay for as long as you need to regulate. And then we'll come down to the earth, bringing your equivalent of a couple of yoga blocks, a blanket, and some firm pillows or those yoga bolsters. Whatever you have handy is the best thing, and I'll see you down there. Here we are, down on the floor. We're going to set up everything for one shape with all the props, and then we're going to take different shapes in our body using those props. So, two yoga blocks or whatever you have handy. handy that mimics this. We're going to take one at a medium height and one at a smaller height. That way we've got kind of like a chair combination going on here, a stepping stone. And I'm going to take one of the bolsters up over that support. So it feels like I've got a little bit of a ski hill here, a little bit of an incline. From here, you can take one of your blankets and you're going to take that into a nice flat rectangular shape and take it to the end of this ski hill. So we've got that incline and we've got that softness underneath us. Just for now, we're not going to use that other bolster or whatever you have equivalent. And if you're chilly, then you're going to need another blanket too. So we're going to take the right hip all the way up to that incline. Knees over to the right. Make sure that you feel comfy. If you need any extra softness under your hip, please take it. And sometimes this, if you've got a nice firm bed, this is best done on the bed because it's nice and comfy there. Your hands are gonna come either side of that bolster. So we're already in a gentle twist here. Snuggle that bolster right into the hip. And from there, laying down. And the right side of the head is supported by that bolster. Once here, any adjustments you need to make to allow that to feel comfortable in your body. The top knee can slide back, you can support your knees in a different way, you can have a blanket or a pillow between them. There is no wrong way here. This is restorative yoga. If you've got glasses on, I would highly recommend taking them off and setting them safely to one side. I'm going to turn over so you can see me from the back. As we settle, option to slide the back hand the other way so it comes and rests kind of behind your pelvis. That way the shoulder can really soften down. Again, make any adjustments you need. Once you're in a place that feels really comfortable for you, then go ahead and close your eyes if you haven't already. Make any last adjustments that feel really good in your body. And I want you to take all of your awareness to the back body, the back of your ribs. And from here, we're gonna start to breathe into the back of the ribs. So on the inhale, imagine as if somebody's resting their two hands on the back of your rib gently. And with your inhale, you're gonna widen and push your ribs out up towards the ceiling, exhaling, following that ocean exhale as the ribs contract as the air leaves. Inhaling and exhaling. Imagine if you could actually still the breath in your belly, in your chest. Everything's breathing from your back body. Inhaling and exhaling. Allow the weight of your body to help with pushing the air out, especially on that bottom rib. Inhaling and exhaling. Every part of your awareness is in the back body. The back of the ribs. Inflating and deflating like a balloon. Allow every exhale to ground you deeper into that support. follow the breaths for another 5 or 6 breaths, nice and slow. Give yourself permission on those exhales to start to rest deeper and deeper down. Stay for another couple of breaths here. And the great thing about restorative yoga is if you feel rested and you feel like you could rest a little deeper, then please stay. If you wish to come to the other side, both hands, palms down underneath the shoulders, drawing the chin in towards the chest, push into the hands, and bring yourself all the way up, nice and slow. And then from there, we'll take the knees away and over to the other side. So smuggling the other hip up against the edge of that support. Any extra padding you need, this side may feel very different. Please take the time for it. Hands either side of the bolster as we inhale. On the exhale, lower the body down, opposite ear to that support. Bring the arms into a comfortable position and consider that back arm rotating in the opposite way so the hand comes supported by the earth behind the pelvis. Once there, making any adjustments you need, coming to the other side. The bliss in restorative yoga is the details. So please take time to readjust yourself and settle in, adjusting the back knee, maybe jaws back, shifting your hips, placing the ribs down in that perfect place for you. And if this side does not feel comfortable, then come right back to the first side. There's no wrong way to do this. This is about allowing yourself to find that rest. And once you're there, softening the gaze or closing the eyes unless you have already, and then take all of your awareness into the back body. Expansion of the breath on the inhale and the back ribs. Exhaling, softening and letting go. Following that exhale breath to the bottom of the breath. Letting the weight of your body naturally push and help the air to release from that bottom lung. Inhaling and exhaling, that smooth exhale breath. Giving yourself full permission to release tension, tightness, thoughts, emotions that no longer serve you. With that exhale, imagine them coming out of your body, down into the support of the earth underneath you, and releasing everything down. Anything that's been bothering you of late, start to let it go. Staying with those beautiful ocean exhales. exhale, allowing yourself to settle deeper and deeper down, inviting that to happen. As you allow yourself to rest, notice if this feels the perfect place for you, and if it is, then stay. If you would like to take another shape, wherever you are, hands either side of the bolster underneath the shoulders, chin draws in to lengthen the back of the neck, and slowly bringing yourself up to seated. From here, taking that towel or blanket, you know, roll the top of it a little so that angle of that incline is a little softer at the bottom there, making sure that it feels like there's a gentle slope. We're going to take that extra pillow or bolster across the mat and bring the pelvis, the back of the pelvis, up towards the base of the support. Second bolster or pillow underneath the thighs, and slowly lowering yourself down, head of support. Option to take a pillow under your head, and then when you're ready, feet come together, knees go wide, adjust that bolster so the back of your legs are supported, soles of the feet together as if closing a book. Hands can rest on the pelvis. You can come down to the earth depending on the range of motion. And palms next to the hips, opening up across the heart space and the chest. An added extra would be an eye pillow or a clean dark sock over your eyes, softening the gaze, so closing the eyes, making any last adjustments to make this feel comfortable for you. There's no wrong way to do it. You prefer to have your legs long and not wide. Any last adjustments, rolling one shoulder blade and another underneath you, so we open up through the pectoral muscles, softening the shoulders, all that work we just did. And we settle into this space, taking your time to refocus on that breath. A great place to stay right here. Awareness in the chest and heart space, and follow that breath all the way in, and then watch that ocean exhale, listen to it all the way as the breath leaves. A great place to focus your attention all the way up here in your chest and heart space, or take your awareness down to your lower front ribs. And focus the breath there. Breathe into the lower ribs. Focus on that ocean exhale, smoothing it out, slowing it down. Great place to stay right there. Or drawing your awareness right the way down into your belly. And then on an inhale, breathing into the belly as the belly expands like a balloon. Exhaling, softening. keep the awareness there or awareness through the belly, ribs, and chest. Breathe as one, inhaling, exhaling, letting it go. Feels comfortable and you're feeling yourself unwind, then stay here for a little longer. Or maybe this is where you stay for the rest of the class. If you wish to come to a final shape, if this is not the most comfortable for you, if your knees are wide, hands come to outside of the thighs, drawing the knees in, feet connect down to the earth with the soles of your feet. Two options here. Chin in towards the chest to protect the neck. Hands rest either side of the bolster and gently pushing yourself up. The other option is to bring the knees to one side, roll to one side, and coming up. And take that bolster off towards the end of your mat and taking that blanket out. A pillow behind your head could be fantastic. Taking the feet either side of the bolster here. We're going to make sure that blanket has enough space here. One heel and then another resting on the bolster. I'm going to take that blanket over the feet, one side and the other, so the legs are fully supported here. And resting yourself all the way down. The bind on the blanket should be tight enough that you can allow your legs to be in space. Feel free to lengthen the pelvis away from you so we take any tension out of the lower back. The pillow underneath your head can be fantastic. And on this incline with the legs lifting up, palms resting at the side of you, anywhere else that is comfortable for you. And when you're ready, taking a big breath in, exhaling it out super slow. Another couple of breaths just like that. On those exhales, soften the gaze, close the eyes, and allow your body to start to melt down into the support of the earth. Allowing everything to pool down into your torso. Adjustments you need to as we come to that deep, quiet rest. If this does not feel comfortable and stable for you, then I'll show you an alternate. If this is comfortable, then please stay. If you don't want to elevate your legs like this, we'll take both bolsters or pillows
underneath your ankles and underneath your thighs. So the legs are elevated, but a little more supported. Taking ourselves all the way down, the pillow or that blanket underneath your head and neck to support you. And of course, any layers you need on top of you as you rest in this stillness. Making any last adjustment somewhere wherever you are. Taking a big breath in. Exhaling it out and letting go. Let me let the breath settle and breathe our body without control. Allowing the body to soften and relax down into the earth itself. Allow the muscles of your face to slide into softness, so the expression on your face simply drifts away. Wherever you are, whichever shape you're in, make sure that it's a shape that your body can unwind in. Just like at the beginning of class, scan down your body from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. Notice if there's areas that need extra care of in this moment that you can have to make adjustments for or can make more comfortable. And then release tension and tightness as best as you can. Take the awareness down to the soles of your feet on those gentle breaths. Imagine the breath coming from the tips of your toes, the soles of your feet, inhaling it all the way up to the crown of your head. And exhaling the breath, moving down through your body, releasing tension. The inhale, guide the awareness to the crown of your head with the breath. Exhale, sweep that down through the body, relaxing and releasing. Starting to unwind and let go more and more, moment by moment. Start to let the thoughts go too. Take a big step back from any thoughts and distractions, sensations that arise. And notice your mind getting distracted with them. There it is again. Noticing this thing, well, there it is again, worrying or concerned or noticing that. Once you let your deeper self rest even more. Letting go of tightness and tension in different areas. And when you're ready to move, simply bring your awareness back to your whole body here, from the tips of your toes to the crown of your head. Starting to sweep that breath once more up to the crown of your head, infusing your body with breath, exhaling it out slow and steady. So we start to allow more breath in the body. And as we're doing that, starting to wiggle fingers and toes, ankles and wrists. Maybe stretching or curling in. If you have those legs elevated in a blanket bind, just take one foot away from the other and that blanket bind will break. And then wherever you are over the next few breaths, drawing the knees in, maybe some movements from side to side, rolling to one side or another, taking some time there to breathe. And in your own time, slowly bringing yourself back up to a seat, whatever that means for you, or another shape that you choose for the end of your practice. And we'll settle into that support underneath us, rooting down to rise. Take a big breath in when you're ready, and on the exhale, let that go slow and soft. Hands maybe come into a gesture of closing. Take a breath in, and on the exhale, drop the chin slowly towards your heart space. And notice how you're feeling in this moment after that allowance of deep relaxation. Get familiar with that feeling that you've cultivated. Take it out into your day and week ahead. From my heart to yours, thank you.